Come on.
6-year-old Nihal Armstrong suffered catastrophic brain damage during his birth at London's Royal Free Hospital. He wasn't getting enough oxygen, but staff didn't check in time. He now has cerebral palsy. Nihal's mother, Rahila, battled for compensation for 4.5 years. 3 months ago, he was finally awarded £775,000.
He has no physical functions at all. You know, no speech, no ability to help himself. And he's totally dependent on my care. Because the money part of it, it isn't important when you start off. What's important is you feel you've got to, you know, justice has to be done.
38-year-old Lindsay Hughes from Clay Hall near Ilford died following an operation to remove his gallbladder. 7 years later, his wife Pauline is still fighting for compensation and an explanation about what went wrong. Her legal bill has reached £170,000.
I feel very angry. I basically just wanted an apology, an explanation, somebody to be accountable for what happened. I didn't want to go through all this. I have no way of paying the bills apart from selling my house. And I don't know where we're going to go.
As few as 10% of the estimated 50,000 people medically injured each year receive compensation. MP Rosie Barnes wants things made easier. Under her private member's bill, money would be awarded without the need to prove negligence. Even victims of genuine accidents would get compensation.
It's very difficult to get anyone to admit guilt and all the medical people to say, well, this is what really happened. You're on your own as a patient with your clothes off and everything's against you. So it's very difficult to prove negligence. And there may well be cases of negligence that are not compensated because you can't prove it.
The bill is backed by leading members of the legal and medical professions, but it hasn't won the support of the main patients charity.
It's very sad that the first opportunity to get something on this topic, on the statute book, actually could do more harm than good. It could leave victims with less information and less compensation.
The fundamental principle of this bill is one that provides compensation in the case of medical accident. And the government doesn't believe that's a proper priority in the use of health service resources.
But many victims are praying the bill will succeed when it gets its second reading next Friday.
Well, I think it's just wonderful that at last somebody has recognised this need for something to be done. And the government has got to see now that they must do something to help us.